In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the best way to complete the bank heist minigame inside of Pet Simulator 99 for a chance to get a huge police cat, which is a pretty amazing reward. If you want to enter any future huge giveaways, make sure to follow these four steps. Number one, you want to like the video as always. Next, you want to subscribe to the channel, because if you aren't subscribed, you are not going to win any huge pets. Number three, you want to watch the video all the way till the end so you don't miss out the best ways to get OP inside of Pet Simulator 99. And last but not least, number four, you want to comment down your Roblox username for a chance to win the huge pet. And with that, good luck. All right, so before we actually go in to a prison vault, I actually have to show you the enchants that you need, because obviously you're gonna need enchants. So these are the enchants that are pretty much what I have. We have corruption, we have critical, nine, pretty much the best tier, you know, critical, treasure hunter, coin, and then fortune. Fortune, I guess you don't need. I kind of use it both because, you know, just to max out the coins. Diluters give you a decent amount of coins. That's why I use both of them. Also speed five, and then super magnet. If you don't have super magnet, don't worry, because you can just use a magnet 3. This thing is very cheap. It's like 16 gems. You can easily find it. And then corruption, if you don't have this one's also pretty expensive. You can actually just use a strong pet, but that one also works. And so yeah, I mean, if you have two extra slots, you could probably use some other stuff like super lightning, or like, I don't know, like fireworks. But yeah, that's with that. Potions, you can also use, I don't know, treasure hunter damage. I know the damage that you have to take is a lot more than like the chest rush from the spawn, if you remember. Also coins, I mean, coins don't really matter because you already have enchants for that. And then also we can go into items, and we can just put on the classic, you know, the classic fruits. I recommend putting on all of them pretty much, because, you know, you could also probably get gems from these areas. So you just put all of these on. You can also put on some of these toys. They're also pretty good. And then also the glitch drive, if you want, like, you know, more boost than, you know, like coins and like diamonds. And so with that, you know, we're ready now to go to the vault. And this is pretty much the vault. So there's actually like I believe like two obbies, or like set of obbies you have to complete to get to the loot areas. And as you can see, we've got three paths. So sorry guys, my huge is earned away, or like my pets. But as you can see, we have decent loot right here. We have good loot over here, and then we have insane loot all the way over here. So insane loot is definitely the best. I really don't recommend going for the bank vault, because this one's like really easy, and it's like decent loot. If you're not really good at obbies, you can go for the good loot. But the thing I recommend most is going to be insane loot. Now this one's kind of hard. It's not the hardest thing in the world, but yeah, it's just kind of like luck with obbies, because like as you can see, I just, you know, the lasers just spawn randomly like around the area. You pretty much just have to, like, you know, get lucky, I guess, because, you know, the lasers can just spawn however they want. We're just gonna see if I can actually make it through. I don't think I can, because as you can see, like, the laser can just spawn. So that thing is like, it's very difficult. But definitely, if you can't do that, you can just do the good loot, because the good loot is a lot better. As you can see, you just go over here, and then this one, you're gonna, I actually completed this one before, and I believe you're going to have to find four digits around like crates and stuff. So yeah, make sure you don't want to cop on those lasers. You just want to find, you know, some like a written I guess letters around. So as you can see, we got one right here. It's a four. I believe there's one behind. Oh, so I just, you know, just go back. All right, and as you can see, we have a seven right here. So there's a four and a seven. We need to find two more. Well, once again, I'm not good at obbies. We just gotta go back. And please keep in mind, guys, that the longer it takes you to do these obbies, the less time you have to actually be inside of the loot area. And as you can see, we have a four right there. I believe the last one should be here. Yep, there's a one. So we have two fours, a one, and I believe us. Wait, what was that last number? I actually forgot what the last number was. Okay, it's a seven. All right, I just kind of like, you know, use my camera to my advantage there. And then you want to pretty much find the keypad, which I believe is on this side. Yeah, so it's on this side. And I believe you can just put them in any order you want. But if it doesn't work, just like type it in a different order or something. If that's going to work, I don't know. Sometimes it won't work, but I don't know why. And as you can see now, we have a crossy road sort of game. You pretty much just want to avoid these cars. So as you can see, I almost died. And then but pretty much like the dashed points are pretty much like, you want to stay on those, because cars are not going to touch them. You want to stay like in the middle. And then as you can see, we've got the loot area. And then from here on out, you pretty much just want to stay in here until the timer runs out, just so you get enough loot and actually, you know, collect some stuff. As you can see, we're getting pretty good diamonds. We're also getting a lot of coins as well. It's pretty nice. You just pretty much want to stay here until, you know, the timer runs out, and, you know, potentially we'll get a huge pet. I did not get a huge pet so far from here. I did get one from like the chest rush back in the spawn. That's my first ever huge pet, but I don't think I'm gonna get this lucky here this time around. And also, please keep in mind that you can't use any TNT like items, or you can't even use flags on this area, which is pretty unfortunate. But yeah, and you can't really use any of those. That's why you pretty much just need to use buffs and also enchants and potions. That's really the only way you'll be able to actually you know, and also like I guess have good pets, because having good pets is also very crucial to breaking these breakables a whole lot faster. All right, so I just finished the bank heist and I got some pretty decent loot, but nothing compared to the huge pet. But the more frequently you do the bank heist, the higher chance you have of getting the huge pet. But if you want to know another way to collect the huge police cat and the most OP method to do so, make sure to check out this video.